As you know, I'm normally a half glass full person, but I've got to say, I think with the way the battle between the Reserve Bank and the federal government is going at the moment, there is a better than even chance that we're going to fall into an economic recession over the next 12 months or so. And it's all because of this good cop, bad cop routine that's being played by the federal government piling into the Reserve Bank. Now, as you know, I'm not a massive fan of the Reserve Bank, particularly Philip Lowe, who a couple of years ago or 18 months ago said, don't worry if you're a business owner, if you're looking to get into property, nothing to worry about. We'll keep interest rates on hold until 2024. Well, didn't he get that wrong? And aren't you and I paying for it in our business at the moment as we're coping with higher interest payments on our corporate debt, our business debt, and our customers are being squeezed by an increase in interest rates on their mortgages. But what's getting under my skin is that the federal government is now piling into Philip Lowe and blaming him for sending us into recession, when it is, the responsibility is evenly divided between the Reserve Bank and the federal government. We've got good guy Jim Chalmers, federal treasurer. I have a lot of time for him. He seems to be pretty intelligent. But you cannot keep going to your market and saying, we're going to give you a pay rise so that you're going to get a decent salary into the future, and not expect that that's going to flow through to inflation and higher interest rates. Treasurer Chalmers, you are the cause of the interest rates going up. Yes, Philip Lowe makes the decision, but don't play the good guy with me, because you're underpinning those rate rises. Now, Jim Chalmers, as I said, pretty good bloke. Disciple of Paul Keating. Okay, Paul Keating, a magnificent treasurer, a revolutionary treasurer, a treasurer that changed our economy for a generation and made it more efficient. A lot of the great momentum of our economy over the last 10 years can be put back to some of the changes Paul Keating brought in. But there's one area, this is why I think there's a link with the way Jim Chalmers is behaving at the moment, is Paul Keating, remember we had the recession we had to have? My great fear is in the back of Jim Chalmers' mind is this is the recession we had to have. Now, that's all very well to say, but the pain that it brings so many small business and so many Australian families is enormous. And I feel for us if we're going in to an experiment of a treasurer that is saying, I'm going to bring revolutionary changes and evolutionary changes to the economy like Keating did, so we need a recession to do it. I think it's a time for all of us to be really careful.